stand a little taller, just a tad?
Like this?
Yes, yes. The chin a tiny bit lower. Gaze a little more to the right. There! Now, hold the pose. Just a few more minutes. You have such an incredibly singular face. That's a compliment, my lord, out of my mouth. Your particularity gives character.
You're still here?
We've nearly finished. Have you any more need of me, master?
You haven't forgotten that we're setting sail today, have you?
Of course not.
Your cousin is nowhere to be found. I've searched the palace from cellars to attics. Your uncle is beside himself.
He was of a mind to paint the town last night. Don't worry, I shall track him down. Make care to your own preparations without wrinkling another frown. We'll meet you on the boat.
It's about time your cousin took account of the responsibilities awaiting him. He should go and inform the ambassadors of Telemi and the Bridge Alliance of his departure.
Have no fear, Master. I will go and see them in his name. I beg your pardon, but urgent matters call me away. Might we finish all this later?
Impossible, my lord! You are leaving with the tide, if what I've been told is correct.
I am sorry, sir, truly. I must be going.
My lord, please, I beg you! Her Highness has personally requested I finish this!
Thank you, cousin, for getting me out of that.
Green blood!
Cut.
And so the day has finally come. My royal fledglings are leaving the nest.
Accompanied by their most loyal and tenacious master of arms.
As loyal as your goal.
Oh, enough with the cold mercenary. I know you like us. Still hiding your men in the unsuspecting shadows of the greats of this world, I see.
Hey, our blades are the only thing keeping you dainties alive.
Ha! Cut! I'm not in need of your protection. I'm no longer a child, you know.
Is that so? Well, let's see. Fight with honor! Yeah!
You defend yourself well, Greenblood. One might think you had a proper master of arms.
The best.
You already training for your new post of legate? Don't tire yourself. Flattery'll get you nowhere. But for the fight, you have remembered your basics. Your performance just got you out of a final lesson. Unless you want to go through the paces again before we depart.
No, thanks all the same. I have quite a few tasks to check off my list before we depart.
And here you are already assuming your political functions. And in a hurry. Always too busy. Very well. If you ever want to go over your basics later, visit one of our barracks on the Isle. You'll always find a training partner to give you a friendly fight.
I'll remember that. Thanks. Are your bags packed for the great departure?
Yes. You know I get by with very little. You're not angry that I'm coming with you, I hope.
On the contrary, I'm thrilled that both you and Sir de Corsillon are joining our party. A few friends at your side in unknown territory is a boon.
Ah, so the old goat is coming too. And there I was thinking I would die of boredom on the trip. By the way, where is our future governor hiding? I was hoping to put his skills to the test as well.
I have no idea. He had plans to celebrate his departure last night, and we haven't seen him since. You know Constantine. I should have gone with him, but my heart wasn't in the mood for celebration. The thought of bidding my mother farewell.
It is never easy to say goodbye. But you should be going to see her now. She must be waiting for you. I'll meet you in front of the palace. Then we'll go and find Constantine together.
Very well. I'll meet you as soon as I've said my goodbyes.
What is this? Have you not been taught to knock? I've asked 1,000 times. Oh, it's you, my dear child.
Mother, I'm sorry. I'm having trouble getting used to your condition.
Come now, let's speak of more pleasant things. I'm so very happy to hear your voice. You remind me so much of your father. I do miss him so. Today is the big day, isn't it? Ready to set sail for that island everyone's talking about.
Yes, but the idea of leaving you behind, alone and ill.
Dying, my child. Alas, there is nothing you can do by staying that would ease my suffering. One thing brings me cheer. They say the island is full of miracles, and we might find a cure.
Even if I were to find it, I would never be able to return in time to...
I know. But it brings me comfort that to know my son has left on a mission to heal his people. Come now. It is time for you to take leave. Here. Take this with you.
What is it?
A family heirloom. Something that... Take it, and keep it with you. May it bring you good luck. All my blessings go with you, my child. Now, be off.
Sorry, Greenblood. Look, we can see the masts of the ship that'll be taking us. This is one sacred adventure we're embarking on.
I hope this island will keep its promises.
In order to know that, we'll need to find Constantine first.
You're right. Maybe he's already at the port. He was so eager to leave.
This will be quite the chore to finish before our departure.
The commander wants to recover some merchandise from our supplier, but the transporter doesn't want to deliver. I did all I could to persuade. Nothing came of it. All the parliamenting fatigues me. But this is your domain. I wouldn't say no to a little help.
Of course. Where is the supplier?
In the lower boroughs, near the port.
Right then. We'll put it on our list of visits.
Where would you like to begin?
I've been asked to pay visits to the ambassadors of Teleme and the Bridge Alliance before our departure. Their dwellings are not far from here. We could go there first.
Very well. Do you think Constantine will be waiting for us next to the ship?
I don't know, but it's certainly worthy of inspection. Your Excellency.
Lord de Sade, I have been told that you were named Legate. Congratulations. Those are great responsibilities for someone as young as yourself. But you will bring honor upon your family and the congregation. Of that I'm certain.
I thank you, Excellency. I've come here to inform you of our departure for Teer Fradee. My cousin Constantine is about to take up office as governor of New Serene, and I'm accompanying him.
I had no idea you would be leaving so quickly. What a shame. I had thought... Well, then, that is a pity. Have a pleasant voyage. A brilliant future awaits you. They say that it is a marvelous island. Please convey to your cousin my congratulations and sincere wishes for success.
You seem slightly hesitant. Please, tell me what troubles you.
A rather unscrupulous individual has been sowing trouble in Serene. A charlatan passing himself off as an alchemist.
Do people actually give credence to these lies?
Alas, yes. They snatch up his celebrated panacea. Remedies worse than the ill, believe me. As you can well imagine, alchemists are our pride. This vulgar trickster casts dirt upon their reputation and our own at the same time. In any city of the Bridge Alliance, we would have arrested him. But here, we respect your laws.
I shall see what I can do, but make no promises. My departure is imminent.
I thank you, Excellency. And I am pleased to see you have taken so well to your new functions of diplomacy. The man operates in the city center. He is said to be clever and mean. Be careful.
I need to be going. Goodbye, Excellency.
Goodbye, Lord de Sade.
Good day, Excellency.
Sir de Sade, to what do I owe the pleasure?
I have come to inform you that my cousin Constantine and I are departing for Teer Fradee on the hour.
Ah, yes. I did indeed hear talk that you had both received callings of greater stature. Allow me to congratulate you. Were you not named Legate of the Congregation?
You are correct, Excellency. I thank you.
It is a station of great honor that I am sure you will fill with brio and panache. The Mother Cardinal Cornelia will be enchanted to work with you, and your cousin in the future. I only regret that your departure is so sudden.
Really?
To be entirely honest with you, I was hoping to solicit your help in a rather delicate matter.
Tell me more about it, and perhaps I can take care of your problem before my departure.
Very well. A small group of dangerous heretics has found refuge in Serene. We know that your uncle tolerates the presence of all pagans within the city walls. But these particular non-believers threaten the fragile harmony of this place. We would consider it a tremendous favor if you would arrest them and deliver them to our guard.
Heresy is not a crime in Serene. You do know that. But I'm sure my uncle would hear your arguments. Why call on my intervention?
The prince would indeed give us his blessing. But it would take time. Far too much time. For according to our sources, these fugitives have already made contact with a smuggler to take them who knows where.
I see. You're hoping that I'll be able to do something before they make it to an enemy city. If your heretics are planning on boarding a ship, then they must be in the dockyards. I'll look into this and see what I can do. I must be going. Farewell, Excellency.
May the light guide you, Desade.
The merchant is there.
Good day, good sir. How might I be of service?
You can start by explaining to me why you refused to honor the orders agreed upon with the guard.
There's been a misunderstanding, sir. Of course we're ready to honor the orders. In fact, I've already had a word with your master at arms.
They're asking that we pay again, despite having already paid.
It's just that the price has gone up since. I've nothing to do with it.
This is inadmissible. If you agree on a sum, you need to honor that agreement.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm just an agent, and I'm only obeying orders.
Your master has apparently asked you to demand a second payment for this merchandise.
That's right. He told me that their attendant seemed to be hiding something when he passed the order. And so he must have thought the guard would end up paying in the end whatever he asked for.
I'll be damned. And I'm the one they've sent to settle the affair.
Sorry, Captain. It's nothing personal. I'm only following orders.
Following orders? Yeah, we hear you. Makes one wonder which one of the two of us is a coin guard.
Why don't we go and solicit other suppliers, Kurt?
When we've already paid for the merchandise. If these thieves agree to reimburse the original payment, it's what we'd do immediately. And do know, in the future, we won't be shopping with them. Well, I should think not.
This whole story sounds suspicious and stinks of a scandal. You're demanding a second payment but refuse to reimburse the one that was already made.
I'm not the one demanding nor refusing. It's my master.
This stubborn fool is pushing me to madness. You understand now why I'm asking for your help?
I don't think you understand who you're dealing with. Perhaps I failed to present myself properly. Lord Desade, nephew of the Prince d'Orsay and legate of the Congregation of Merchants. During our conversation, you explained to me that your master forced you to commit a crime. That's regrettable. Especially as you will be considered his accomplice in extortion, theft. You know as well as I that the congregation does not tolerate such illegal activities.
But I'm only obeying orders.
That is a shame. Well, as orders are the only language you seem to understand, I order you to return the guard the merchandise without delay. Unless you'd rather your master is hung and that you finish your days in prison.
As you request, my lord. I shall go immediately and ask that these crates be delivered to the attendant.
Now that's a wise decision.
Thank you. I was beginning to think this would never end. You're certainly honoring your new title. Bravo! The quartermaster must be expecting us.
Lively there, lads and lasses! I promised the merchants and their prince we'd be off before the tide. You, man, carry that properly. That porcelain is worth more than your life. There are some children we'd be best to refuse.
Captain Vasco.
And you are?
I'm De Sade, the prince's nephew. If all is in order, we will soon be embarking on your boat.
It's a ship, not a boat.
Apologies.
Apologies for my asking, but the young governor isn't with you.
He didn't come home this morning. I need to find him before departure.
I hope nothing's happened to him or he hasn't changed his mind. The tide does not wait.
Perhaps he simply celebrated his imminent departure with a little too much enthusiasm. Is everything ready?
We're short a crew member. The cabin boy is missing. But have no fear, we will leave without him if he does not present himself before the tide.
Is he an important member of the crew?
We don't need him for sailing or navigation. He's only a cabin boy.
He must have simply had a bit too much to drink in celebrating his departure, like another I know.
I doubt that. Jonas was never one to fancy drink. And it's been 2 days since last he was seen. No, I fear something bad has happened to him. Might I ask you, if you hear anything, could you report it to me? I would like to set sail with a clear mind.
Be back soon, Captain.
Citizens, I present to you Panacea, the absolute cure of everything. Toothache, stomach ailment, and even an open wound. This potion heals all of that. And more still, this little phial is the product of years of research and intensive labor. I hear you asking, if this remedy can heal one from the Malichor. Alas, not yet. But your question is legitimate. I am so close to finding the cure. But the Malichor isn't the only ailment causing you to suffer. Not true? Then don't miss out on this chance and give yourself a healthy and energize life! Rejoice! A file only costs a few coins, and well worth it, to make your life shiny and new again!
Does it really heal everything, your potion?
Everything! Absolutely everything! Except the Malichor, of course. That being said, it is known that those in top health resist the Malichor best of all. Then don't throw away this chance. Think of all the pains that this potion could help you avoid.
You are right! It's a deal! I'm gonna take two!
There's a man that knows a good deal when he sees one. Hurry now! There won't be enough for everyone.
There he is. He's our man, no doubt.
His speech is well polished.
You're finally tempted.
In all honesty, I haven't made up my mind yet. I want to be certain that I'm not dealing with a charlatan.
In this day and age, I can't blame you. What might I do to convince you?
Are there any nasty side effects with this remedy of yours?
There are none. You will feel nothing but an intense sense of well-being.
Will you drink one of your potions to prove your good faith?
Of course. I take a little sip every morning. But as I'm in perfect health, you won't be able to verify the improvement in my condition. But if it helps you make up your mind, give me just a moment. There now. As you see, I am still in excellent condition.
Come on now, I saw you take that vial out of your pocket. Nothing proves that it's the same potion that you sell to your clients.
As a man of science, I consider skepticism a remarkable quality. But in your case, it is not skepticism, but blindness.
We need to steal one of these potions and force him to drink it.
Brilliant idea, Kurt. Let's take a look at his cart. Good day, tavern keeper.
Good day to you. What is your pleasure?
Has the Malichor really put a damper on your business?
More than a damper. They were soaked. When the sickness began to spread, a wave of panic followed in its wake. People stopped going out of their homes. They were afraid. I was close to closing shop, I tell you. And then, thankfully, the alchemists of the bridge said that you couldn't just catch it like that. People are still distrustful, as is their nature, but they are leaving home again. It's a start. I also lost quite a few regular customers. Dead or too scared to venture back. Oh, but that's nothing new to you. The city would have sunk in the water if not for trade with the new isle.
How is business going these days?
It's picking up. We've not seen many new customers, but of late, things are looking better. The Malichor and the neighboring walls have dampened commerce. The epidemic still rages, but the possibility of finding a cure on that island has given people something to hope for. Now that we have a city there, quite a few seafarers come by to spend their wages.
With all these sailors coming and going, you must have heard some stories about Teer Fradee.
Right. Even stories that my heaviest drinkers would have trouble believing. They say that man trees live there. Dragons and gigantic creatures. Treasure abounds under every rock. And the source of eternal life is hidden somewhere there. Last night, some noughts even told me they brought back one of those giant beasts into the pool. Ah, but you know the kind. If you ask my opinion, the drink was fueling their imaginations.
I'm looking for my cousin. His name is Constantine. I believe he was intent on celebrating his departure last night.
There was indeed a party here last night, but it ended badly.
Whatever do you mean?
A brawl broke out. My tavern was shattered, and no one's paid for the damages.
I'm sorry. Amongst the rebel rousers, did there happen to be a young man? 20 years of age, hair down to his neck, light brown, blue eyes, quite the talker.
I don't believe it. Of course he was there. He's the man that started the fight. I hope you've come to reimburse me. Don't count on me to help you if that's not the case.
What kind of damage are we talking about exactly?
A good half of my furniture was broken into firewood. I piled up the lot over there.
Let me take a look. Perhaps it can be repaired.
If you can fix it, I'd be obliged. If not, you'll need to pay. Well then, were you able to repair it all?
No, I haven't been able to sort them out.
In that case, you need to pay me, sir.
I regret I don't have the sum you're asking for.
Either you repair them, or you reimburse their cost. Or I keep what I know about your cousin to myself.
That's ridiculous. He could reimburse you easily. He's quite a rich man.
Perhaps, but a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush. And as for promises, I've heard enough to fill an ocean.
Very well. I will see what I can scavenge in that case. I need to be off. Farewell.
Goodbye.